Frederic.
Yes, my friend.
What should someone do? They're lower middle class. They got a boring three-bedroom brick veneer home. They got a newish car, and they want to get a piece of art. What would you say to someone? And they would say, I don't know what I should get. What would you advise them to do? Besides coming to Urban Galleries, yeah. Sorry, Urban Paradise Gallery at Surfers Paradise, mm-hmm. What else would you do? How would you pick what is your niche?
A friend of mine went the other day, went on Gumtree.
Yep.
Noticed there was a sculpture for sale at the Southport RSL. $360. I got it wrong. It was $80 they pay for this very large hand-painted Stanislaus sculpture, which is about 2 meter high by 300 wide and 200 wide. Yeah. And they bought that for $80 from the Southport RSL. Yep. It's an amazing piece of art. I straight away, when I saw the artwork, I said, I'll give you $82 for it. But yes. They wouldn't take it.
Yes.
And it's all about opportunities. It's about looking around. It might be on Gumtree. It might be on anything else. You can find art out there at your own leisure and within your own means. You don't have to spend a lot of money. Actually, buying art should be like a haggling system. You know, you should meet the artist, you should talk to them. Here's, you know, it's all about talking, it's all about relationship. So make sure that you develop a relationship with artists, or you spot the right opportunity in the right time, in the right place.
Tell me this, Frederic, how long does it take for an artwork to become valuable?
Well, depends on how long the artist is going to live. You know,
yes. Really, is there any way we can get rid of them faster?
The earlier they died, the more valuable, the faster it becomes valuable. But you can't kill all the artists in Queensland.
No.
It'd be very difficult to do so. Although Bob Catter, I reckon, is not far from trying to do that.
Yes.
Bob Catter mentioned last week that there was no homosexual in North Queensland. And I think if they are, they better just keep it very quiet.
The funny thing about Bob Catter, I don't know if you know this,
no,
but he was actually a state minister.
Oh, God.
In the Bjelke-Petersen government for heritage and arts. So
nervous laughter. Sorry, Bob.
Yeah, no, Bob's okay. But the thing is there, I've got to be honest with you, you know, the artwork itself, it's a personal thing.
It is.
And if you like the flea market puppy dogs painted in concrete, well, that's just your thing, isn't it?
Absolutely. I think art is not about, you know, art could be your kid. Your kid's artwork. You take your kid's artwork done at kindergarten or year seven, you frame it and you put it in the house. That's your artwork. It's a movie poster that you've picked up while on a trip in Hungary or in Rome. It's a sculpture you bought while you were in Bali. It's a table that you saw around the corner in a shop. Art is whatever
you want. How much do you need to spend to get some good art? Let's not muck around. In the gallery, what do we need to spend? $1,000 will get you good art?
Well, it depends how gorgeous you are, really. Generally, I would say for about $150,000, you could build the number three best art collection in Queensland for sure.
150,000, become number three.
Yeah.
I see.
There's a couple of people there before you that are, you know, they've committed millions, literally.
Yes. Now I understand what you're saying. It's very undervalued, isn't it?
Very undervalued, yeah. And you see, the way that these people make money, I'm talking about very important tycoon that have started collecting art.
Yes.
They buy the artist. They generally sit on board of the Gold Coast Art Gallery, for example.
Yes.
They have companies that allow them to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars in buying art.
Yes.
Those artists they spot, they then introduce to the art gallery, they have exhibition, they become famous, their price go up, and then they sell them just at the right time to make money. And it's nothing less than just a knowledge of, you know, how you play the stock market, you play the art market. And artists are desperate enough most of the time to play the game.
I see. Are you a desperate artist yourself, Frederic?
No. I'm not desperate at all.
No.
I couldn't care less about, you know, wanting to make millions out of my health. I just want to have a lifestyle. So yes. For me, it's all about lifestyle.
I'm the same. You know that I'm the same. I've got the same credos there. It's good. Very true. It is lifestyle. And
I give myself the permission to. When I deal with politicians and I don't like the way they're going, I'll just say, no, sorry, I'm not interested. You know, I'm quite famous for being someone that disagree with politicians locally, yes. You know, and therefore yes. I assume that totally. That's because...
Would you still sell them your artwork?
Most of them wouldn't buy it anyway.
Yes, the stingy fuckers.
I dealt for years with councillors like Councillor Krishlo. She's only interested in koalas. You know, I like bottoms and breasts and...
Yes. How do you mean she's only interested in koalas?
Yes.
I like furry animals.
I like very much furry animals as well. But certainly when you deal with people like Councillor Krishlo, which is stuck in the 1950s, as a contemporary artist in Southport, it's very difficult to make a living.
Yes. Understood. Thank you so much.
Pleasure. Jay.